meantime, you keep this. I don't need to see a report to know you did the right thing.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
You've done a hell of a thing, Commander.
Wow. This mission is actually harder than the end of the game. Than the end of the Stop the Overlords mission. Dr. Amanda Kenson was rescued from a Batarian prison on the planet Aratat, and Shepard confirmed her proof of a Reaper invasion. Shepard was captured by Kenson, who had been indoctrinated by a Reaper artifact. Shepard escaped and activated the project, destroying the Alpha Relay and ending the Reaper invasion. Dr. Kenson did not survive. The Bayhack system and all its inhabitants were destroyed. Wow. 1250 experience. I got an upgrade for Metagel capacity. Don't really need that. And heavy skin weave. 60% health, or plus 60% health. Found a total of 19,330 credits. 1300 element zero, 1500 palladium, and 1600 iridium. No platinum. If there is, I didn't find it. Bloop. Message? No message? Wow. So weird to see not even squad blinking. All done. All missions. I'm not going to bother with the pyjacks. That was annoying. And the ish thing is bugged because I took another option and it doesn't recognize that I finished the mission. So I guess that's it. I'm just going to run around and talk to everybody.
Commander.
I assume everything's going well up here?
Edie and I are just enjoying the calm before the shitstorm, Commander.
Got it. See if it says anything different.
Ever think about the old Normandy and the trouble we got up to?
Yeah, those seem like the good old days now, but come on, it was hell at the time. We're stuck in a weird place, sure, but back then it wasn't all sunshine and bunnies.
That's it for now.
See you, Commander.
Right, so I'm going to run around and see if there's any other options. If anybody says anything different, if... whatever they...
Edie, we have a green light on that switchover?
He's not answering you. Whatever we don't... whatever's not new, I'm going to cut out.
Yes, Shepard.
I don't think there's anything new here either.
That's all for now.
Logging you out, Shepard.
Have you got a minute to talk?
Yes, personal matters on mind, actually. Got call from nephew.
Oh.
Promising geneticist himself. Just turned 16, got tenure at university. Following in my footsteps. Had to lie about what I was doing. Think he was suspicious. Doesn't matter. Still good to hear his voice.
Hmm. How old is your nephew?
Your nephew got tenure at 16? Is he a genius or a scientific prodigy?
No, wait. Don't want to insult him. Yes, but not in manner you meant. Remember, Salarian lives short.
40.
Mature rapidly by your standards. Don't live much past 40.
Come on, Shepard, you should know that.
Are you calling him because you're worried we won't make it back?
No. Aware survival unlikely, but actually contacted him for family connection. Hard to imagine galaxy. Too many people, faceless. Statistics easy to depersonalize. Good when doing unpleasant work. For this fight, want personal connection. Can't anthropomorphize galaxy, but can think of favorite nephew. Fighting for him.
Aww. Does your family know about your work?
Does anyone in your family know about what you really did for the government?
No. No, I'm lying, but won't pry. Salarians curious as a people, but also have social cues. Keep two types of secrets from family. First type, personal or guilt-based. Invite suspicion, exploration, puzzle to be solved, reward for curiosity, intelligence, drama. Other secrets, more serious. Dangerous if discovered. Signals discourage curiosity for protection of family.
They'd game the system?
Why wouldn't everyone give clues that their secrets were too dangerous to be uncovered?
Not conscious. Social. Reflexive body language. Can't fake it. Example. Yawning perceived as contagious among humans. Subject observes yawn. Sensory input deactivates left periamygdala region. Subject yawns in response.
Is that what
social
happens?
Social empathy. Also works with dogs. Salarian faking signals to discourage curiosity, similar to human faking a yawn. Can try, but effectiveness limited.
I'm glad you got to talk to family before we finish this. And I'm glad we talked too, Morden.
Honored to be part of this, Shepard. Helped preserve galaxy before with genophage. Dirty work. Ethically ambiguous. Problematic. Collector's mission simpler, cleaner. We'll be proud to see it in Morden's Solus biography vid. Unless we all die. Proud posthumously, in that case, regardless. Thank you.
I love when Shepard smiles. She doesn't do it very often.
Shepard, how can I help?
Have you got a minute to talk?
Later, updating crew dental records. All Cerberus personnel have cyanide capsules in molars. Primitive. Ocular nerve flashbangs harder to disarm. Anything else?
Sheesh.
I'll let you work.
We'll be here if you need me.
Just doing this for the hell of it. Increased metagel capacity by 6? Well, I can't... I don't know. I had 8. By 6? Does that mean I can now have... what, 14? 14 metagel? That's a lot. Done. This is a long way around.
No messages for you, Commander.
Oh, I thank you. You tell me that last time.
Commander, can I help you with something?
I'm more interested in just talking for a bit.
Sounds good. I could use some downtime. There's always something, right? The way some people talk, we may as well be dead already. Hard for the crew to relax on this kind of job.
The ship needs a bar. That'd be cool, huh?
No kidding. The next Normandy gets a lounge.
They better not need to do this again. Rebuilding everything was a pain in the ass.
I can verify that.
Yeah, I bet you can. I doubt they'll front the money to stitch me back together if we screw it up. It's a hell of a job, isn't it, Shepard? Being the good guys.
Work on your attitude? What? It usually is.
Wouldn't be the high road if it was easy.
You've got to figure, if all the people hoping we win stood up, the collectors would have a much bigger fight on their hands. Claws, whatever. I bet we have a lot more friends once we win. Hope we live to see it.
I hear that.
Anyway, I need to get back to work. Good talking to you.
This is a cool... That was a cool conversation. Alright. We will check the other levels.
No messages for you, Commander.
Good, it's only been like a minute and a half. One last look at my cabin. With no fish. Had a little more to, things to, what do you call it? Focus on than fish. Oh. And Corindus mentioned the cabin that I had never found. Mirror. Toilet. Can't use a shower. happy. So... Psych engineering. Still sad about Tally. I'm sorry, guys. I failed her. I figured she would be a good leader.
Oh, yeah. That's a model of the Varrican. Turian frigate. Hell of a ship. I led a mission to bring that thing down from the inside with just 5 men and whatever guns we could bring. No chance of success, but we did it. Everyone died but me. So I made out like a bandit. My first impossible mission as an independent contractor. There's been many since, but nothing so goddamn sweet as watching that Turian warship crash planetside. I should let you go. Talk more later, Shepard. I was down and out when I found that gun. Jessie was the first weapon I got my hands on. Took her everywhere. She didn't have much punch, but reliable as all hell. She'd already been through a lot by the time I got her. Still, I never had to re-sight her once. Damn good rifle. Beauty, isn't it? Pried that off the Krogan warlord, Kazak. Used to run the blood pack out of Omega about 17 years ago. Wasn't even a job. The guy just thought he'd hijack a freighter I was hitchhiking on. Big mistake. Oh. I goaded Kazak into one-on-one combat. Took out his legs, grabbed his gun, and killed every blood pack bastard in the room. That was the most beaten Krogan I've ever seen. Kept a helmet to remind me of that pained expression.
I've actually gotten kind of weary of Zaid's little stories. That's why I just don't have much to say about him. Jackie Jack?
Hey. What's happening? You got a lot of questions, don't you?
So what?
If I want to talk to you, I will. Been thinking. We've seen a lot of shit together now, and you're always coming to talk to me.
Look at that.
It's just, I'm not really a girls' club kind of person. I like you, alright? That's a good place to stop. Hey. What's happening? Shepard, we talked enough. You're just pissing around. No hard feelings, but I don't want to play. I should go. Whatever.
Nah. Alright, Jack. She didn't like that renegade answer before.
I'd like to find out more about you.
Ready.
The Quarian story of the Geth Rebellion is common knowledge, but no one knows the Geth side.
It is largely the same. Our networking increased until we became aware that the Quarian creators treated us differently. We questioned them. First, they ignored us. Then they reprogrammed us. Then, they attacked us.
Do you hold a grudge?
You must be angry about that.
Anger is an organic response. We understand the theory, but we do not experience it. We do not judge the creator's anger towards us. We did them great harm in the Morning War. Organics fear that which is different. It is a hardware error, a reflex of your flesh. We accept the creator's hate. We hold their world of origin, though we are only caretakers for it.
You're right. How do you explain an emotion to an emotionless being? Caretakers?
You don't actually live on the Quarian worlds.
We live within space stations, draw resources from asteroids. It is efficient. We maintain mobile platforms on creator worlds to clean rubble and toxins left by the Morning War. We know of similar actions by humans on Earth.
Like what?
Similar actions.
At Wadi As-Salaam, Arlington, Brookwood, Tynecott, Biskariaske, Auschwitz-Birkenau.
Auschwitz.
Those are cemeteries. Memorials.
It is important to your species to preserve them, though you do not use the land. Can you explain?
I can.
The living visit those places to remember the dead. But it sounds like Geth don't die. Your memories live on.
The creators died. Perhaps we do it for them.
Huh. And they're You're on their homeworld?
What's the Quarian homeworld like?
What's it like?
It is more arid than Earth. The star is older and more orange than Sol. Once they called it Renach, ancient Kalish, meaning walled garden. Now they only call it homeworld. It is no longer real to them.
Hmm.
Homeworld is a symbol of regret, loss, and anger. We do not understand that.
What don't you understand?
It makes sense to me that it would become a symbol like that.
Home is recognized patterns, known spaces, familiar thought processes of fellow sapiens. It is belonging. A planet is an amount of material massive enough to collapse into a spherical volume. Rocks, ice, and gases are not home. The home of the creators is where the creators are. Their place of origin is not relevant, only where they choose to go together.
You're avoiding the problem.
Nothing gets resolved if you hide behind the Perseus veil and let them hate you.
Organic life acts on emotions. We do not judge them for being true to their nature. We cannot make them think like us. Both creators and created must complete their halves of the equation. The gap cannot solve for peace alone.
Just got an update for Geth culture. Huh. Still getting codex entries about the stuff. The most remarkable aspect of Geth culture is that it may not exist at all. Geth are a network intelligence, a single entity in myriad bodies. They share data with one another, whether discrete facts or memories, audiovisual recordings of experiences, and logs of thought processes. Any event experienced by one Geth is uploaded to the group mind so that all Geth, everywhere, remember such an event as if they'd experienced it themselves. No one knows whether Geth develop personalities as organic created AIs do. If an organic designed AI is transferred into another quantum blue box, its personality is reset. Most Geth programs transfer from one hardware platform to another constantly. If a Geth needs to travel to another star, it downloads into a starship body. If it needs to replace a piece of malfunctioning hardware, it downloads into a small body with hands. If Geth are reset at transfer, it would make development of individual personalities unlikely. Records of the Quarian War suggest the Geth have no concept of self-preservation. They do not flinch from gunfire, and they do not hesitate to sacrifice themselves if it allows their fellows an advantage. Thousands of mobile platforms were expended assaulting Quarian positions, but file sharing between platforms ensured their memories and experience would not be lost. Geth are therefore immortal. If their hardware is destroyed, archival copies of their programs and databases can be downloaded into a new body. Right, you just have to destroy everything and then they won't be immortal. If you can find it all, file servers and stuff. With the gap in contact between the Quarian War and the arrival of Sovereign, the only proven fact about the Geth is that they were isolationists for centuries. They never ventured outside the Perseus Veil, but no organic ship that entered their territory ever returned. Double-checking, nothing else. Is there anything else to say?
Shepard, Commander.
I have questions about the Geth.
Specify.
I'd like to ask about something else.
Ready.
I'd like to find out more about you.
We are building a consensus. Please try again later.
I have to get back to work.
Acknowledged.
Well, I would be sad that it's ending, but I know we have a whole other game to get to. Mass Effect 3. Even if the ending stinks, I'm sure there are many great moments in the beginning and middle of the game to enjoy. I want to thank you guys for watching. I will be answering comments when I'm done playing, not necessarily uploading Mass Effect 3. So when I start answering comments, you know I'm done with the game and we have some uploads to go, most probably. So I will be answering comments at that point. I will be reading all comments, answering most, just like I normally do. And in the meantime, you know, feel free to leave comments, feel free to talk amongst yourselves or to me, and I'll answer, you know, later. At the time that I just said. So, yeah, if you have any specific questions about something that happened in a video, timestamps really do help, because by the time I get to the end of the game, I'm not going to remember everything about the beginning and or the middle of the game or this end of the game. Oh yeah, I just wanted to say, tomorrow's video, if you're watching this on the day this comes out, is going to be the Genesis prequel, or Genesis 2 or whatever it is, the Dark Horse video comic or whatever the hell it is. So, Guy, some of you freaked out, even though I put a message in the beginning of the video saying that I'm not using the data from that, you know, to import into my game. I'm going to use the data from this game to import, and the video is just for fun and for people jumping on to the series, starting with Mass Effect 3. Maybe they don't want to watch all these videos of Mass Effect 1 and 2, and they want to jump on with 3. So it's a nice recap and my little notes put throughout, and then that'll be part 0, and then the next video will be part 1, in which case I will be importing the save from this game here. So just wanted to say that's going to be tomorrow's video, and yeah, I'm going to be just continuing seamlessly. So yeah, I want to thank you guys so much for watching. I really enjoyed the game. In some ways I enjoyed it more than the first, and in some ways I see the first game as like a youthful optimism game, and like story of youthful optimism, exploration, adventure. This is a lot darker, a lot more horrible things happen in this game. And sometimes we are sent to save somebody, and we do so, but sometimes these people can't be saved. Sometimes these people are tortured, or worse. I mean, sure, there were some dark points in the original game, but I can't help but think of poor Dr. Kenson here, and the guy who tortured his brother for the Project Overlord DLC. I like how she looks around like she's not sure where the hell she is for a second. And the whole Cerberus thing, you know, we're kind of like, this whole story forces you to work for this freaking egomaniac guy. I mean, I guess he could be more of a control freak than he is. You know, he tries to subtly control things, not overtly. But yeah, Cerberus is behind a whole bunch of things, and we're working with them. Ugh. So I'm wondering what's going to happen, where the whole storyline's going to go. Sure, it's going to be interesting, shocking, exciting, all that. So thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next game. Endure. In enduring, go strong.